So today we're going to show you actually how to set up your telescope, how to point your telescope, and then some of the things you can do with your telescope both during the daytime and the nighttime. Now, so firstly, your telescope will probably look like this. You will have the base, you will have the telescope itself, and you'll have some sort of either handle or knob to actually insert it. So we're going to take you to the step of actually putting it together so you can observe it. So if Matt, you want to grab it?
Yep. So you just want to grab the body on the left and right side and just slowly slide it down until it sits nicely.
Now, in theory, your telescope should sit there without any knobs or handles there. And now in this case, we have handles. Now, Matt, there's two different ones here. What are the differences?
Yeah, so one of your handles has some bearings in it and the other handle has no bearings. And you want to put the handle with the bearings generally on the same side as the eyepiece, just for easy access.
Now, what do the bearings do?
So they're gonna lock off the telescope so that we can move it up and down, and then you can slowly let it go, and it'll let it freely ride. So you wanna put that one up reasonably tight.
And so when you lock it, it locks it into the place on the sky.
Yeah, it locks it into position. And the other one, you want it probably just, once you get to hand tight, just keep going. Not too tight, because if you lock it off too tight, you won't be able to move the scope when you want to. So now if we just turn that a little bit left, you can see I can move the scope, turn it right, and it's going to lock off and sit there. You sort of want to find that happy place where it's locked, and you can actually still move it up and down, and when you let go, it'll sit just like that.
And the knobs work the same way, right?
Yes, yeah, so you actually don't want to touch the right knob at all. You just want to touch the knob that's on the same side as the eyepiece, just to sort of lock off there.
Now, we have another part here. So what's this? We call this the finder.
Yes, this is your mini telescope. So first thing, you want to just take off the two dust caps there. I like to put these either in my pocket just to save them, or in this part of the Dobsonian just there.
They definitely do go wandering at night.
They do, yeah, they do. Pockets are, yeah, they're probably the best place. And so if we just turn it this way, sliding on the finder scope just goes in the back like that, and there's a little screw you can tighten up there. Once again, just hand tight as hard as you can go, and then that's fine there.
Now, the next step is we obviously have to take the dust cap off.
Yes.
Now, this is too big for my pocket even. So yes, I do the same thing because I slide it underneath here.
Perfect.
It's hard to get lost. Now, we have the eyepiece.
We do. So you want to make sure that you have an eyepiece in, and generally you want to start off with the eyepiece with the lowest magnification. And the easiest way to remember which one that is, it's the one with the highest number.
So the biggest number, in theory, the biggest one is the lowest magnification.
Correct.
Now, why is that?
Because when you look through your telescope, you want to be able to find an object. If you have the highest magnification, it's really hard to actually see whereabouts in the night sky you are. So you want to do low magnification, so you get this big window of the night sky. And then once you've locked onto your object, you then want to swap that out for a higher magnification.
And so we have everything on, and now we're ready to start observing.
There's actually a few more things we need to do just with the finder scope.
Okay.
So actually, before you observe at night, one thing you want to do is set this up, and you want to set it up roughly where you're going to use it, just at about dusk, and you actually need to align your finder scope.
Okay.
Because sometimes when you take it out of the box and it's been stored away, you actually get a little bit of movement, and you can see we've got three screws here. And these screws actually adjust the alignment of the finder scope. They need to be perfectly aligned, so when you look through this, you're looking at exactly the same thing as this.
Okay. So what is the first object you usually choose to align it?
Yeah, I usually choose something in the distance, either a tree on a hill, and you don't want the whole tree, you want either the base of the tree or a telecom tower, so like a flashing light in the distance.
Or maybe like a distant street light or something
like that.
Street
lights work perfectly
as well.
Not
your neighbor's house.
No. Yeah, don't do that one. And so, once again, you just want to point your Dobsonian, and usually it's in a horizontal position because you're looking a long way in the distance. And the first thing you want to do is look through your finder scope. And in the middle of your finder scope is this little crosshair. Then you want to look through your telescope. Then you want to come back to your finder scope. And what we need to do is we need to align this to this. So once this is actually looking at your streetlight, we then come back to your finder scope and just move these left and right. And what they're doing is they're putting pressure on your finder scope to move it up and down and left and right. So that eventually, if we're looking at a street light, The street light is locked in here, and we then want to lock it into the center of the finderscope.
And so now it's aligned, we can find it, just have to wait for it to get dark.
That's it, that's it. And so with waiting for it to get dark, you can literally just put your scope in sort of like a home position, just up like that. Just leave it there. This is really good for the mirror to get a little bit cool, to come to ambient temperature. It might be a few hours, and then we're ready.